Hi guys! So today, before I start this video, I just wanted to talk to you guys for a little while because, first off, I want to say hi because I know you guys haven't seen any videos from me for a couple weeks, and the last video I came out with, I promised you guys are going to be more consistent with videos, and we clearly have not kept up with that promise. And that's really because some really amazing and awesome things have been going on over here in our lives, and we are going to be moving across the country to California. I'm actually going to be working with Chelsea Smith Cosmetics, and I get to play with wigs all day, so I am so excited. I cannot wait, and we are super excited for this new adventure. But with that being said, it has literally turned our world upside down with just trying to find a place and getting our house packed. We lived in this house for almost 9 years, so there's just a lot. I have to get all of my wigs put away, and you know that's gonna be a whole process, so it's just been a little crazy. We also are so close to 5,000 subscribers. And when we hit 5,000 subscribers, we are gonna be doing a really, really large wig giveaway. There's gonna be about 5 wigs involved in this giveaway, including one that you get to choose, one from my collection. I've got a ton of different kinds. Most of them are really the ones that I absolutely love and feel like they're great beginner wigs, and they give you a lot of versatility in your look. And then you're also gonna get a bunch of my absolute favorite products, and you can win it for free. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel and you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and make sure you hit that notification bell. You'll get the notifications for all the videos I do in the future, and let your friends know, all of your wig friends out there, that this is where you can come to really learn about wigs and learn how to make every single wig that you get your own wig. So with that being said, I want to go ahead and get into this video with you guys. Today I am going to be showing you how to alter slash cut off the ear tabs on a lace front synthetic wig. All right, so like I said, I am here today to show you guys how to alter the ear tabs on your lace front wigs. And this is something that is actually relatively pretty easy to do. It's just one of those things that's a little scary because it involves one single thing, and that is a pair of scissors. And if you don't know what ear tabs are, they're this little area right here that literally kind of cover right in front of your ear, and then they go right around your ear and usually covers your sideburn area. Some of them do, some of them don't. It really depends on how far down they come. It also can be an area where a lot of us have issues with sizing. In general, most of these very generalized sized wigs, you get a lot of this area right here in the front that is kind of too big, and it flops over your ear. Like, your ear is underneath it sometimes. It could come down way too far. It just doesn't look natural. So there is a way to go ahead and get rid of that excess area that you don't need. And it's really very easy. I just want to show you guys exactly where to kind of cut, because we are going into the construction of this cap, and we want to make sure we don't cut anything that's going to mess up the wig permanently. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how to do this now. We're going to go ahead and get in nice and close. All right, so the first thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna head to take your wig and you're gonna flip it inside out. This is really something that's gonna be a lot easier for you to do on a wig head or some type of mannequin. You can do it on a willing participant, but you wanna just be careful that you don't cut any of their hair, own hair or anything like that, because that would be bad. You're gonna wanna slowly take this away. So don't just go in and start hacking, because you can always take a little bit away at a time. But once you take off, obviously, a big chunk, you can't put it back. So we're gonna go ahead and just start off really small. I do have a mark here of where I kinda want it to be. It's hard for you to see it on the camera, but it kinda goes right here. And I'm still gonna keep this nice curve that I have. I'm gonna go ahead and not come all the way up to the line that I marked. I'm gonna do about half of that, just to make sure, double check that this is really where I want it to be. I always just get a little nervous, so I always just say, like, start a little bit lower than where you actually mark, just to be safe, because you can always go back and cut some more off. So we're gonna go ahead and kind of keep this curve happening. You wanna start right where the lace starts. So the biggest thing when you're doing this, and the most important thing to remember when you're doing this, is do not cut into any of this area that is not lace. And you also wanna make sure, when you're cutting over in this area, you want to try to stay away from any kind of threading or anything like that. Just be very careful when you get close to this area and you're cutting, like these corners here, because then you're starting to get into the construction of this part of the cap. And not to say you can't repair it, because you absolutely can, But it's another step and another thing you're gonna have to deal with. So you wanna just try to avoid all of this area. You just wanna stay where the lace is at, and then you shouldn't have any type of problem. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna cut here. I wanna start right up against as close as I can get without messing with this construction part of the cap. And I'm just going to take my lace and I'm gonna cut right here. Something else you want to just be careful of when you're doing this is you want to really hold this away from the wig hair so that you're not cutting any extra hair that isn't attached to the lace right here itself. So we're going to lose obviously the hair right here that is coming off with this, but the goal is just really to try to keep from cutting any of this hair underneath. So just pull away when you're doing it, and then all the hair is going to lay flat like this and down, and you shouldn't cut anything that you don't want to remove. So we've lost a little bit of hair here, and I'm just gonna go ahead and clean this up just a tiny bit. Make sure that it isn't jagged or anything like that, just like when you're cutting. And then the other thing you wanna just do, and this is something that I kind of always forget to do, is I wanna just take my hands and just run it through right here. Because a lot of times when you're cutting lace, especially lace that has hair and knots in it, sometimes you cut right in the center of a lace grid, but the knot doesn't come off, and then you just can see the knot hanging there. So I just like to take my hands and just really make sure that I don't have any knots that are there for no reason, if that makes sense. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and just wipe like that, and we got all that out. All right, so now I would just put this back on my head and make sure that it is exactly where I want. If it isn't, again, you can just kind of repeat the process. If you really have like a ton, you can also come in here a little bit further if you need more of a rounded out area for your ear. And I'm not gonna do this because I don't need that, but you could take your scissors and you can cut. And instead of going just straight down like this, you would come up this way and then go down. So you'll have this nice little cutout if you need that. And that's another way to do it too. The biggest thing with this, especially if you're doing this after you've cut the lace on the rest of your wig, is just making sure you clean it up so that it follows it nice and goes right in there so that you don't have any jaggedness or weirdness in that transition between where you finished your cut and the rest of your lace. But other than that, it's a really, really easy kind of thing to do. And it's a great place to start if you're having issues with the sizing of your wig. So I just want to show you guys how to do this. Again, it's not crazy hard. It is a little intimidating because we're coming at it with scissors, but you will definitely like the results, I promise you. Just take the first cut, it'll be okay. All you said, I quit. All right.